of last 4-5 question papers, and that is on portal method. So portal method, this is approximate method of analysis. Now analyze portal frame as shown in figure by using portal method. This was asked in December 2017. So now if you remember, we have three assumptions. First, mid span of the beam is an inflection point, mid height of the column is inflection point, and third, we have interior column shear is twice that of external column shear. So using this, so this is third assumption, that internal, you can see this, we have two H1, so we have internal shear that is twice that of external. So we have 4 H1, so -H1 -2 H1 +18 = 0, and therefore we have H1 that is equal to 3 kilonewtons. Similarly, this is at middle of top story, then we have to go middle of next half story, but we have to consider all the loads and frame above it. So we have the next, that is 18 kilonewton, 36 kilonewton, and we have this value as H2. Then we have again 6 H2, and that is equal to 36 plus 18. Again, summation fx equal to 0. And from this, we will get value of H2, that is equal to 9 kilonewton. So H1, 3, and H2, 9 kilonewton. So now we have first assumption, that is mid height of the column is inflection point. So you can see this. So we have, this will be first assumption, or second, we have, that is mid height of the column and mid span of the beam. So you can see this. We have, this will be again for next floor beams. So we have these all are inflection points. So now we are going to consider the portion separately, A1, A2, then A2, B1, B2, and B1. So this is T, then we have this T, then we have this as L. And then we have this as T, then this as plus sign, which is joint F. So one by one joint we are going to consider. First, we are going to consider joint A, then we will go for joint B, and portion we are going to consider between the inflection points. Then we have C, D, and likewise. And then in second, we have E, F, G, H, likewise. So now we will go first with joint A. So we have, this is H1, we have seen 3 kilonewton. So we have a height of column 4 meter and a span of beam 5 meters. So we have taken half of. So we have now three unknowns over here, that is VA1, VA2, and HA2. Now we are using first by summation FX0, which will give me value of HA2, and that is 15 kilonewton. And then we will take moment about A20. And by this, I will get VA1 equal to 2.4 kilonewton, value got plus, means assumed direction is correct. And then we have summation FY0, and we will get VA2 also 2.4 kilonewtons. So you can see that is shown in the diagram. Now we will go with joint B. So we have this as joint B, and we are going to show that is load acting on joint B. So we have 2H1 now becomes 6. So whatever values we have at A2, we are going to show same value at this A2, but in opposite direction. So we have that is 15, which will be towards right, and 2.4 downward. And then we have three unknowns, which will be VB1, then VB2, and HB2. Now we will first use summation FX0, gives me value of HB2, which will be equal to 9 kilonewton. And then moment about B2, if we will go, then we will get value of VB1. And that we will got as 0.4 kilonewton. Value got plus means it is upward. And then we will apply FY0. So we have -2.4 plus 0.4. So it will get VB2 as 2 kilonewtons. So we have this value 0.4, 2, and 9 kilonewtons. Now we will consider joint C. Now I have not solved this joint C. This we can do easily. So we have this joint as B2. And we know at B2, we have equal and opposite. And therefore, we will get 2 downward, 9 towards right. And then this is 2H1. Then summation fx, we will get value that is HC2, that we will get as 3. And then if we will take moment about C20, which will be minus 2 into 5.5, then minus VC1, that is into 2.5 plus 6 into 2 equal to 0. And if you will solve this, then you will get this value of VC1 as 0.4. Then you can apply summation FY0, so 2 downward, 0.4 downward, it will get 2.4. And by summation FX0, already we have this value HC2. Now then we have joined D. Now 3 we know, that is value of H1. Then we have C2 value 2.4 downward, 3 we have towards right. And then by using FX0 and FY0, we will get this VD1, that is equal to 2.4. So these are the portions which are in first floor. Now we will, that is top floor. Then we have next floor. So we have VA1. A1 values, you can see we have 3 left and 2.4 downward. So here we will get 3 right and 2.4 upward. Then we can have 3 unknowns here. So that is solved over here. Then you can see summation fx equal to 0 gives me value of HE2, and we will have HE2 is equal to 30 kilonewton. Then take moment about E20, which will give me value of VE1. So 9 into 3 minus VE1 into 2.5 plus 3 into 2 plus 2.4 into 2.5 equal to 0. VE1 equal to 15.6. Knowing VE1, we can get VE2 by FY0. So we have minus 15.6 plus 2.4. And if we will solve this, we will get 13.2, which will be VE2 value. Then we have joint F, then we have E2 values, we can have, this will be actually value of H2, this 9 kilonewton, if you remember, we have this will be H2 value, and then we have here 2H2, that is 18 kilonewton. So 30, then we have, this will be at B1, if we will go to the last slide, then we have to find out three values, which will be VF1, then we have VF2, and then we have HF2. Then summation FX equal to 0, I will get value HF2, and that is 30 plus 6, 36 minus 18, so I will get 18 kilonewton. And then you take moment about F20, so we have these values, and which will give me value of VF1, and we will get 2.6 kilonewton. And then VF2, by applying summation FY equal to 0, we will get value of VF2. So now we know these values. VF1, we know values of VF2, and now we will go to the next joint, which will be G joint. So now we have these values which are known from previous, and we have unknown VG1, VG2, and HZ2. HZ2, we can have 18, 18, we can have these 2, 18 gets cancelled, and then we have only 6. So we have the HZ2, that will be 6 kilonewton. And then we have to find these two values. So if we will take moment about G2, we will get this as 2.6. And FY0, we will get this as 13.2. And then we have that is H joint. So known values you can see. So we have, this is from D-win. These values are from D-win. Then these values are from G2. And this is our value of H2. And unknown is only this vertical value, 13.2 plus 2.4. So 15.6 we have in upward direction. So likewise, we have these values. Now we have to plot bending moment diagram. So we have this as inflection point. Now we know we have this as 3. So we have 3 into, we have this distance that is 2 meters. So 3 into 2, so we have 6. Now you can see this 6. So we have due to loading, this will be outward. And our fixed end moment, that will be opposite of this. So this will cause tension inside. And then we have this will be 3 into 2, 6. Now, if we will go to the next joint, which will be 2H1, 6. So 6 into 2, we have 12. Then we have 6 again, 6 into 2, 12. And here we have 3, 3 into 2, we have 6. Then we have for this 9, H2 value is 9. So 9 into 3, we have 27. Then 9 into 3, we have 20, sorry, 18, 2H1, H2 now. So 18 into 3, 54. 18 into 3, 54. And then we have 9 into 3, 27. So these are the bending moment diagrams for your column. Now for beams, we have to take vertical forces 2.4 into 2.5. We will get it as 6. Now you can see this. So due to 2.4, we have moment in this fashion. So due to fixed end moment, or we will have opposite moment, and it will take your beam downward. And then we have, this will be 2.4 into 2.56. Then we have 2 into 3, 6. Then we have 2.4 into 2.5, we have again 6. Then here we have 13.2 into 2.5, 33. Then we have 11 into 3, 33. And then we have 13.2 into 2.5, that is 33. So we have, these are the bending moment diagrams which are for your beams. And in this diagram, we are showing both, that is beams and columns. So this is first problem. Then we have, this problem was asked in May 2018 for 12 marks. This is for 10 or 12 marks. We have loading is changed only. There we have 3 bays. Here we have 2 bays only. So now here we can go in the same way, 25 kilonewton, which will give me value of H1, which will be 6.25 kilonewton. Then I can go 4H2, and that will give me value that is equal to H2, 18.75 kilonewton. Then we have, these are the inflection points. So that is mid height of the column and mid span of the beam, or mid span of the beam, correct. So we have, these are the inflection points. Now generally give name to the column as 1 and for this beam 2. If we will give this 2, then it becomes difficult. 1, that is little bit difficult over here. Here G2 we can have I2, but we cannot have H2 over here. So now we will go one by one. So first we have taken first part G joint. So now I will go a little bit fast. So you can see this, we have calculated a G2 value. Then we have taken moment about G2, and that will give me value of VG1. Then we have applied FY0, then we have 5 kilonewton. So then we have this joint GH. So H, we have known values we have shown here. This is 2H1, so 12.5. Then we can have summation FX0, gives me value of HI2, 6.25 kilonewton. Then take moment about I20, and that will give me VH1, 0.83 kilonewton value. What plus means, assume direction is correct. FY0 gives me 4.17, that is 5 minus 0.83, and that will be 4.17. So we know these values now. So we can go to the joint I, and then we have at joint I. So I2, we have 4.17, 6.25, and then here we have FY0, so 4.17. Then we can have joint F, and we know values 18.75, these values we know at G1, and unknown we have again 3. So we will take now FX0 gives me value of HF2. We have HF2, 37.5 kilonewton. Take moment about F20, that will give me value of VF1, which will be 25 kilonewton. Then I can apply FY0. So 25 minus 5, so I will get it as 20 kilonewtons, that is VF2. Then I can go to the joint E, and then I will show the known forces. At F2, we know both values. So this is 37.5 is 2H2. These values 12.5, 0.83, which are at H1. Then we have at F2 these values. Then we can have FY0. So that is 37.5 plus 37.5 minus 12.5. So we have 12.5 that is remaining. Then take moment about D20, and that will give me value of V1, 4.16 kilonewton. FY0 gives me value 16.67 kilonewton. Then I can go to the D joint. So now I know value at I1, I know value at D2. So just apply FY0, I will get this value, that is 20.84. And then we are in the same fashion, that bending moment diagram. So we have 6.25 into 2, 12.5, 12.5 into 2, 25. Again, we have 12.5. Then 18.75 into 2, so we have 37.5, then 37.2 into 2, 75, and again we have 37.5. Now we can go to the beam. So we have 5 into 2.5, 12.5. Then we have 4.17. And that value we will got it as 12.5. Then 20 into 2.5, 50. Then we have 16.67 into 3. And that we will get it as 50. So we have these values, and this is our final bending moment diagram. So now we will switch over to the third problem. So we have December 2018, 12 marks. Then loading is changed only. So we will go a little bit fast. So we have these values. I will just show you. You can see this. So H1, 12.5. Then we have H2. We got value that is equal to 32.5 kilonewton. Then we will consider first all inflection point. Then we will naming it. This naming plays important role. Then I will go to joint G. Same way we have to go equilibrium equations, and we will get values. All three unknowns we will get from here. Just take moment over there. Then you can go with joint E and joint H. And then H we have again Fx equal to zero. So we have value of HI to 12.5, then about I20, VH1 2.08, then we have VI2 6.25, show these values, then take I joint, known values you can show, apply FY0, so you will get VI1. Similarly, you can go with second floor beams, then we have F, and then we have these three unknowns, again apply FX equal to zero. HF2, we got 60. Take moment about F20. We will get VF1, which will be 49.16 kilonewton. Then apply FY0, you will get VF1, that is 49.16 minus 8.33. Then joint E, just show all the known values. And then you can have FX0. Then you have FY0. By FX0, you will get value as 20. That is 65 minus 65 plus 60 plus 25. So that will give me value as 20. Then take moment about D20, which will give me value of V1, 12.28 kilonewton. Then apply FY0, we will get 13.63 kilonewton. And then join D, we have V known values at I1, we know values at D2. Then just apply FY equal to 0. So 30.63 plus 6.25. That will give us VD1 value. So likewise, we have to again go for bending moment diagram. Now you know this. So 50, then we have 25, then 32.5 into 3, we have this as 97.5, then 65 into 3, we have 195, and this is again 97.5. Then for beam, we have 8.33 into 3, then 6.24 into 4, then 40.83 into 3, 30.63 into 4. So likewise, we have these values. Then this is problem which was asked in May 2019. So this was asked for 12 marks. So 16, H1, we will get it as 4. Then H2, we will get it as 12. And now we will go to joint by joint. So these are inflection points, naming of the inflection points. And then we will consider one by one joints. So first we have G. So we have calculated value of HG212, then we can have moment G2 gives me VG2, then we have these known values VG2, this is 2H1, which is 8, and then we can have FX equal to 0, gives me HI2 value 4, moment about I20 gives me VH1.4, apply FY0, so we will get value VI2 2 kilonewton. And then we can have these values, I joint, so we know I2 values, and then we can have FY equal to 0. So likewise, we can go for F. Now I will just show you, you can go through it. You will get all these three unknowns. Then we have joint E, you can see over here. So likewise, we can go with this. And from this, we will get all these unknowns. And in the same way, we are going to be with your joint D. Known values, 4 only. So 10 plus 2, we have 12. And then we can have this one by one, that is inflection points we can have. So you can see this, and then just multiply it by vertical distance, that is half distance, you will get bending moment per column. Now you can go for beam. So we can have 2.4 into these distances. So we will get these values, and this will be for your beams. So likewise, we can find bending moment diagrams. And so this is all about your questions which were asked in university examination, that is last some papers. So this is all about your question paper problems by using portal method. So thank you. Good night.